last week on Around the World for Free.
You don't have a dime in your pocket?
Not a dime in my pocket.
We left New York City and with the generous help of supporters, made our way down the East Coast and over to Puerto Rico. And this week, we go island hopping in the Caribbean without a dime.
Captain's taking us out, putting us on his dive book.
From the U.S. Virgin Islands.
Show me where the iguanas.
To the BVIs.
This is it, Alex. This is the Bomba Shack.
To the undiscovered paradise of Dominica.
We have not seen one soul hiking down here, not one person.
We're up in these rainforests, just tripping. And we're above the cloud lines, as you can see.
All the way down to Trinidad.
Take a look. Some of the most beauty we've seen in the Caribbean, to be honest.
Does everyone know where New York City is?
That's all coming up on Around the World for Free.
Hi, I'm Alex Boylan. I made it my mission to circumnavigate the globe without any money. The reason? To see the world in the purest way possible, through the eyes of the locals. To mobilize the global community, we created a website where people could interact with me daily. This was my lifeline that would connect me with locals worldwide and to help me continue my journey around the world safely. At least that was the plan.
Dude, what was that?
I set off from New York with just one crew member, Jolt Luca, and not a penny to my name. No security, no hotels, no script, no clue where we were headed. Just a couple of cameras, an open mind, and the entire world ahead of us. My goal, to eat, sleep, and live like a local wherever the journey takes me. From the untouched lands of Dominica to the urban jungles of Venezuela. From the raw spirit of Africa to the impoverished struggle of Cambodia. You're watching the true chronicle of an unimaginable life-changing journey. So hitch a ride on this trek from our great American home through the Caribbean, South America, Africa, and Southeast Asia before pointing the compass home. 4 continents, 16 countries, 45,000 miles. Welcome to Around the World for Free. I'm flying into the U.S. Virgin Islands from Puerto Rico after some great new friends there sprang for my puddle jumper ride.
And a girl, Christy, had called and said she's going to pick us up from St. Thomas, drive us to St. John, where we have a house. We can crash out for a day or so before we continue our journey. I worked here, this part of the islands, 10 years ago, and I never came back. Here we are, St. Thomas.
Hey, how are you? Welcome.
Look at that.
There you go.
Well, thank you for reaching out.
Now, I only need one thing while you guys are here. Will you come and speak to my Sunday school class?
Absolutely.
It's all West Indian kids.
Are you kidding me?
You're pretty much content being here now?
Pros and cons. Definitely pros and cons. I'm single, and down here they say the odds are good if the goods are odd, which is very true. If you're a professional person, you can just forget it. If I wanted to party every night, great. I could probably find the man of my dreams. But seeing that I do have a regular job and a couple businesses, it's a little more difficult. But my family's here, so that's a pro. There are only 4,000 people on the island. It's one of those things that I'll complain about it while I'm here, and then when I'm away, I really miss it. Like, I miss the people. The people on St. John are phenomenal. So we're just entering Red Hook, which is where the ferries and the barge from St. Thomas to St. John go.
This building, I don't think, was here.
No, that they just opened up this week.
This was like, no one was even around.
This was just dirt. Like, there was one barge.
Yeah. Wow.
And then there was another guy named Jojo.
Yes.
Around?
Yes. These are just like outlying keys right here. Congo, Mingo, Lavango, and I'm probably gonna keep messing them up.
Coming across, the sun is setting, it's magic hour. One of those times that you just cannot really even describe.
Hey, Christy!
I mean, I'm looking at all these bars like cows.
Hey, Sheila. So this is your house. Perfect.
Oh my gosh. Well, are we on the island yet? I think so. One of the many things Christy does down here in St. John is vacation property rentals. And she gets us into a sweet villa for a couple nights before the next renters arrive. Caribbean bliss indeed. It's still not too late to hit up one of Christy's local hangouts, Pickles.
A lot of people like kind of lost from the 60s that are still here and never left. It's definitely cool. People, what you see is what you get.
Cheers.
Cheers.
This is the real deal.
Just another day in the office, right?
I've been here for about 8 months. I think I'm gonna have to stay for at least 7 years. But the tourists are treated differently. They are. We call them Turons.
This is her mom.
Anyway, come in for lunch. You'll get a free lunch tomorrow for your journey. Come on.
Thank you so much. Hey,
nice to meet you. Good luck.
I appreciate it.
Next day, Christy gives us a spin around some of her favorite spots in St. John.
Some people do the 30-minute gridiron. No, not here. We roll on the boat. Thou shalt not park here. So right now we are headed down Centerline Road. This is gonna take us all the way to the other side of Coral Bay. Nice sleepy little community. You've got a lot of kind of lost sailors, pirates. This was one of the first forts on the island, and they would watch as pirates would come in and they could fire off shots. I mean, we're talking Pirates of the Caribbean. I mean, it's real, and we're living it. Are going to my church so you guys can speak to my Sunday school kids who are going to get such a kick out of what's going on.
I am a Virgin Island, emerald on the sea, where beaches bright with coral sand and children's bliss our native land.
My boys are here.
Morning, everyone. How you doing?
And
Joel. Oh, hi, guys. It's okay.
Where there are two guys going around the world. They've gotten from New York City to here.
Is there a place that you guys have always been curious and interested about that you want, almost like if I could make it there, I'd be like, I'm doing that for you guys. China? China? China. That would be interesting. You know, China, is it Japan? You're giving us two hard ones right out of the gates. New York City.
Jamaica. Washington, D.C. Jamaica.
Oh, interesting. Good.
Show me where the iguanas here on the island. It's right here, buddy. Willis, you come on. Why don't you try to catch it, man? Willis, right there. Have you caught one before?
Yeah.
Really?
About 500.
You caught 5 of them.
Right here we have baked coffee. We have vegetables, a veggie lasagna, chicken, and baked chicken. We have peas and rice, and we have a salad. And right over here in the corner, we have mixed vegetables.
Great. Caribbean food.
It's like authentic West Indian, just real healthy. Some rice and chicken, it's good.
Coming up on Around the World for Free.
Go, go, go!
A way cool boat ride to the British Virgin Islands.
I would like to invite Alex Boylan.
All right, how we doing, all right? Yeah.
Where I get a totally unexpected job.
Okay, did you see that speech? What am I doing?
That's next. I've been enjoying the sights.
Are we on the islands yet? I think so.
Sure. The flavors.
It's like authentic West Indian, just real healthy.
And the welcoming spirit of the U.S. Virgin Islands.
This is the real deal.
It's been great to just bump into old friends around town.
You know I married him, right?
I know!
Want home today. It's like I never left, never went away. I want home today. It's like I've been a
rubber
bomb, never went away.
I know this guy.
Blast from the past.
I have to give a huge shout out here, okay? I worked here almost 10 years ago.
This means a lot more than most
people. Experience it, feel the love, that's it. That's why we call it Love City.
Can I explain to you what these smells bring back to me?
Ever since we arrived in St. John, Christy has been trying to find a way for us to move down island.
I'm looking for, can you get online and get the Seabourn schedule? Seabourn Airlines didn't come up.
And then web community member Deborah from Tortola in the British Virgin Islands, right next door, reaches out and offers to put us up. We don't even need a plane to make this jump.
No, we're just rushing to catch a boat so you guys can get over Tortola. We gotta get you off U.S. soil. One of my friends pulled through with his boat.
The red and white flag, it's got a blue awning.
That's the boat we're taking?
That's the transport.
Lily's staying with her grandma.
There's a picture in my phone of you.
This is it, Coral Bay Harbor, you know?
Getting rid of you guys.
Captain's taking us out, putting us on his dive boat, getting us to Tortola. This is it, saying bye to St. John.
In the U.S., we have Flanagan Island, also the Duck Island, which is right back over here, are both bird sanctuaries.
Not too shabby at all.
Go, go, go!
We're soon in Tortola. Give a big thanks to Christy, and coming out of customs, we're greeted by this driver in a car that's supposed to take us into town.
I don't know how we've gotten here with Around the World for Free, but somehow I'm checking in some hotel in a place called Road Town, Tortola. Not too bad. I'll take that. They're picking me up right now.
All of a sudden, I get in this van, I find myself with the top motivational speaker in the island.
CW Terrific Robinson, sweet Antigua and Barbuda in the heart of the Caribbean.
Headed to a university where they're expecting me to give a speech.
We are having a wonderful student empowerment session this evening.
That is Debbie Hodge.
Hey, Debbie.
How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good.
I'm sure you're happy to be here, aren't you?
I'm very happy.
Alex, great to meet you.
To welcome you all to the fall semester student assembly. Welcome. At this time, I would like to invite Alex Boylan.
All right, how we doing, all right? Yeah. First of all, I have to say to everyone here, you guys are gonna be in good hands. And but people ask me, how did I get on The Amazing Race? How did you get on this like primetime television show? But the reason why I bring that up is that it all started from one thing, making that audition tape. Like I had an idea, I wanted to get on the show, and I actually acted on it. And I just gotta say to all you guys in school right now and going out into the world, like, follow your dreams. I mean, go for it. I mean, one idea, if you act on it, it's amazing that what can happen. By the way, I'm gonna be leaving in a couple days, so if anyone knows how to get me out from here to point B, please let me know, because I don't have anything. All right, so thank you very much, and I appreciate it, all right?
Okay, did you just see that speech? What am I doing?
I didn't hear you say yeah.
All right, so I'm not a master like CW Terrific.
You know when you have a burning desire, you don't give up until you have accomplished.
Maybe all I need is a little practice with a younger audience.
See the school? So we're on our way going in, and we'll see what we have to offer in here.
So here I am at this school, and like people are expecting me and stuff. This is like wild.
Does everyone know where New York City is?
Yeah.
Have any of you guys been there?
Yeah.
Say hi to everyone.
Hello.
Every one of you guys wave. Say hi to everyone.
Hello.
This has been like maybe the funnest time I've had so far. These kids are full of life. Now CW's taking over and just rocking and rolling, but like, wow! Oh my God.
You a winner? Are you?
Yeah.
Let me hear you say, I'm a winner.
I'm a winner.
Yeah! Give me a five, boy. It's just awesome to know that I can help them to bring out the very best in them, help them to see beyond here, and to help them to recognize that there is no limit when it comes to their potential and possibility.
And you thought I had a lot of energy. When I'm coming to these kids and talking to these kids, I'm loving it. I could do this like the whole trip.
So put your hands together. Welcome, Mr. Alex Boylan.
You guys can connect with people who live in, you know, in India.
It's funny. This whole thing's funny. It's like a couple days ago, I was in Puerto Rico bartending, and then I'm like chilling in St. John, and now I'm like motivational speaker. It's like, what is next? Coming up on Around the World for Free.
What's your favorite story of this place?
Oh, man. There's so many.
The BVI's hidden gems. We are the only ones here. And we move on to untouched Dominica.
I guess that's why Jay's been living here for the past, like, 26 years. I know a good thing when I see it.
That's next.
If I could make it there, I'd be like, I'm doing that for you guys.
Sunday school speaker in the U.S. Virgin Islands? Check.
Say hi to everyone.
Hello.
Motivational speaker of the BVI's? Check. Onwards.
Amor, ábreme tu corazón.
As a reward for my work with the school children, Debbie is taking me to see some sights in the British Virgin Islands.
This is it, peeps. Virgin Gorda. Just that boat ride out there, I mean, just so beautiful. And we get there, and I gotta tell you, Virgin Gorda is beautiful, but they have this place called the Bass, and it's these caves. And you walk down, it's crystal clear water, and it's something, it's indescribable. It is so beautiful.
This is so cool. I wish I had a day to hang out here.
You could go in, swim, chill out, all that other stuff. It's nice growing up here, you know. You could leave the front door open.
Back in the day, this is where our forefathers apparently used to work and toil, so we're trying to actually preserve it.
Back in Tortola, we stop in a one-of-a-kind place.
This is it, Alex. This is the Bomba Shack. Every full moon, every month, this is the hottest spot on Tortola.
They have these huge, huge full moon parties. Everyone knows about the Bomba Shack here and in the islands.
What's your favorite story of this place?
Oh, man.
Just give me one.
One of my favorite. Dang, so many. Okay, one full moon, this lady came up to me and she took a panty off, put it on top of my head, and the panty said, tease me, please me. And I had to do that all night long. Yeah, a lady sent us that one the other day. You like that one, huh?
Yeah.
That's a huge one.
This is where I grew up. This is where all my family live. And this is just home to me.
Hello.
This is where I come almost every week, get my fresh bananas and some cane and avocado when they're in season.
Is this all grown around here?
Yeah, so we call it my father plants it up in the hills.
Oh, he cooking some ital, he says.
What's that? Ital, you call it Rasta food.
Rasta food.
Oh, that's veggie and provision mixed with coconut milk and beans and then mix up.
This is my mom's house. Don't dare try to get out. My brother has a huge dog.
Don't dare get out of the car.
Dude, I don't like that dog.
My friend Alex
doing?
Oh, that looks good.
In my day, when I got my kids, we didn't have any daycare, but the neighbors used to pitch in and take care of the kids, and you could go to work.
Thank you so much for letting me in your home.
That dog's scaring the hell out of me. Let's get out of here.
Too much fun, but it's time for us to move on.
Now, Deborah and the locals here so they can get me down on. They've been saying that for the past couple days. Well, I talked to Deborah today, she's like, I can get you to Dominica. Now, there's a user from Dominica, Jay Grimner, so I'm gonna reach out here and see. Is this Jay Grimner? Hey, what's up, man? It's Alex. Everyone has just been raving about Dominica. Like, you have to check it out. It's like the island with the rivers, and yeah, so we were like, let's do it. He just said, before we even get back to his house, we're gonna stop by a waterfall. All right, cool, man. Well, if there's anything changes, I'll give you a shout, but if not, I'll see you tomorrow at 2:30.
Just got a 1 week to get out of here. We don't know where you're gonna end up.
Thanks so much for everything, Deborah.
Thank you.
Apparently, it seems like you're going to Dominica.
We're gonna miss you, Deborah.
We're gonna miss you too.
We're in the air, but not towards Dominica. We gotta fly back to Puerto Rico first for our connecting flight, and the layover's not quick.
This is probably the worst part of my day. Look what I have to look at. That looks good.
Here's the deal. Joel can eat since he's crew. I'm going around the world for free.
Okay, so if anyone doesn't know, I made $30 when I went bartending. And I spent a little bit in St. John, so I won $24.
That'll buy you this. Going to do it?
No, I...
How hungry would you have to be to actually go up and then ask for someone's leftovers?
I don't know. I would probably say 48 hours in our need, telling people, like, going up and being like, hey, buddy, give me a scoop of rice. Well, might be coming soon.
Despite the empty stomach, we move on.
We set out into a land that, like, Jolt or I know nothing about. Okay, this is not Dominican Republic. No, this is Dominica. I'm telling you, I've never seen beauty like this before. It's spectacular.
Great to have you here. Welcome to Dominica. Both of you guys, welcome here.
I've been here for 26 years. I wanted to see the Caribbean, so I went from island to island. Planned to spend a couple days in every place. I got here and I just loved it so much. Basically, I never left.
We're not even driving 10 minutes.
Oops.
I think you got a flat again.
No, I think my muffler may be touching.
Muffler is like scraping across the ground. No worries, you know, right on the side of the street. What does Jay have?
Oh, you guys want a sandwich?
Yeah.
We got some drinks there. We got beer.
Yeah, coke, man.
Orange juice. Here's the sandwiches.
Look, let's stop and have a picnic on the side of the road.
He brought a picnic along, sandwich. I haven't eaten. I was actually talking about it in the airport today.
Yeah.
And how big is the island?
So 30 miles long and 15 miles wide, and very mountainous. But we're on our way to the Carib territory first. We're going to take the long way around.
Dominica, it's the only island with original inhabitants from way back, and the Carib Indians, which is actually the Caribbean was named after, and we had to drive right through their land.
Made the whole Dominican aware, and now they're being proud that they have something unique where no island in the Caribbean that have original Kalinago people. It's a people that history have wrote about them, and they are there.
This is like a full-on rainforest.
Yeah.
We are the only ones here.
Yep.
Nobody. Look at this place. And it's just this, you know, maybe like 40-foot waterfall dropping down. Water's about like 72 degrees, and it's just us. It's like, yeah, this is just one of the many that are here in Dominica. It was like very, very cool.
I mean, like hiking down here, we have not seen one soul hiking down here, not one person. And this is full on like rainforest. I guess that's why Jay's been living here for the past like 26 years.
Yeah. I know a good thing when I see it.
After a bit of a drive, we get home. Jay quickly like starts cooking up some like Chinese food.
I was in Afghanistan right out of high school. I ended up in France going to school in Europe. I went for a little trip to the Caribbean. I ended up in Dominica and I said, oh my God, this is beautiful. They were desperate for French teachers and they hired me on the spot. and I've been your hero ever since.
His daughter comes home.
So you all like what you see?
That's an understatement.
I can honestly say I've never seen anything like this before.
First meal in Dominica, love it.
Once again, you feel like I've known these people for years. I just met them.
Best place in the world. I've been everywhere.
Coming up on Around the World for Free. Ever rappelled into water?
These guys are like naming their own waterfalls.
And a trip to a boiling lake.
We just found a sign of life up here.
It's not flying, it's just hopping.
Has anyone gone swimming in it?
No, it's too hot.
That's next. After only a few amazing hours in the undiscovered paradise of Dominica,
this is like a full-on rainforest. Look at this place.
I'm ready to see what this island is really about.
Woke up this morning and look at this view. Not too shabby. One thing we've found out since we've got here is that Dominica is all about eco-adventure. Now, Jay's good friend runs a canyoning thing in the mountains.
What's the plan today? What's the plan?
Boy, the plan today, we're going up to the valley. And we're going to do some serious canyoning.
Canyoning in
water.
In water. In like rivers is what this is. It's like you're canyoning, like rappelling through like rivers.
Jeffrey works with the owner of Extreme Dominica, Richard.
I came down here to buy a bar and restaurant and then I bought a cottage. When we did canyoning, we didn't even know we were canyoning. We thought we were just doing some sort of adventure.
That vine there, that's what we use, you know, so I cut the machete, I cut that, and I put it, I tie it around a chair, and I said, well, Richard, let's go down that vine, man. Let's go see what's down there.
We remains. Beautiful waterfalls in there. It's just fabulous.
You know, you have this daring spirit, so you decide, well, look, guys, you know what? Let's go see what's there.
We called it the Falls of Charm, and it's still known as after my daughter's name, Falls of Charm.
These guys are like naming their own waterfalls. That's awesome.
Before, there was no way we could attempt the big waterfalls, but now, with all the stuff we got, there's nothing that's unattemptable.
So excited right now.
Do not take the hand off the rope. Do not move your feet until you are completely horizontal.
On the way back home, we stop at another one of Jay's friends.
That's my friend Screw. This is his place.
Yeah, man.
Screw's hot water, sulfur spa.
How cool is this? This is Screw giving us a personalized tour.
This land here, the water wasn't flowing. I had to dig from day one. I just was driven, and it took me for 4 years. I started digging here, and I went up right here, all up here, because all up here is a big pool. There's a big pool there. And I got the first water here. Yeah, and I couldn't believe it. I go up there like a little boy, man, in a candy store, bawling out, yo, I get it. Yo, I get it. I get the water.
You see the bubbles here? What water? Boiling out.
I just the water and the nature, and it's freaking me out, and I want to bathe in it, and I want to, I see in the vision. And we're willing to share it with you. Remember that, y'all?
Yeah.
Jay tells me there's one more must-see place in Dominica and sends another friend my way.
I'm Alex, man.
Jackson.
All right, Jackson.
We're going to go hike up to the
Boiling Lake.
Boiling Lake.
Oh, we got a ride.
Locally, we call this a guamye. The sap of it basically will catch it on fire, most certainly. If you're in the forest or if you're at home, you don't have gas, you could use this as your gas right here.
We're up in these rainforests, just trippy. I mean, we're above the cloud lines, as you can see. I think one of the other cooler things is it's just me and Jackson. You hike for maybe a couple hours, you come up on this ledge, eventually you start coming down, and you hit this place called the Valley of Desolation. Nothing can grow here because of all the sulfur, but it's still a lot greener than I thought it was going to be.
We just found a sign of life up here.
It's not flying, it's just hopping.
We actually use this sulfur and put on our skin. You take some of that and pass it on your hand.
This is what we just hiked from, way up there, like 2 hours back there. We just came over that ledge, followed the hillside all the way around to where we are here. After a Valley of Desolation, maybe you hike for another hour and boom, you come up to the Boiling Lake.
Has anyone gone swimming in it?
No, it's too hot there. Just really swimming in.
How hot is it?
This boy's for up is 265 degrees. We had a guy who fell in there and he was burned from his waist to his toes. And then they had to ship him to Martinique for treatment.
I guess this is either the largest or the second largest boiling lake in the world. And I mean, it's just boiling right in the center. You gotta ask yourself, you know, why isn't the lake just boiled away? But if you look off to the side, there's a river. And that river is like a cold river that's running into it. How all that works is truly phenomenal. But it's definitely a hike getting there. The hike going back is probably twice as bad.
We have not stopped for hours. Just never stopped. Or I'm just out of shape. That's probably what it is.
Coming up on Around the World for Free.
Anyway, South, I mean, I'll work too.
This is crazy.
Who'd want to leave paradise?
Maybe I can work on the boat.
Maybe. I don't
want
to stop here. I
want to
keep going.
Oh, cool.
Well, it proves a lot harder to do than we expect.
Let me call you right back. Let me hang up.
That's next. After canyoning into rivers, chilling in hot pools.
This is what we just hiked from. Way up there.
And a brutal hike to the Boiling Lake, my adventures are winding down. We gotta keep heading south, maybe as far as Venezuela even. But no one's reaching out from the web community, so it's time to head into town.
We're in the city of Roseau, the capital here of Dominica.
We meet up with one of Jay's old students, Ariana.
So Jay's hooked us up with her, and then their friends have this place. They said, come on in, get a bite to eat.
Thank you. Have
this is roti. Roti is a typical Indian dish. It's curry. It came to us when we had indentured servants.
I've never had anything like this before. This looks cool. If you were us, and you had $22 to your name, what would you do to get off this island?
Express des Iles.
That's a What's ferry.
That? How much is the price of the ferry?
I think a little less than 200 or about 200 EC, yes.
$80 US.
Something like that.
Maybe they would. Maybe I could work on the boat.
Maybe. Go to the Venezuelan embassy and beg for them to ship you out. They do have military planes that come in here pretty often.
Military plane?
Oh, yeah. You know.
This is the Venezuelan embassy. And I contact this lady named Francesca. I'm not sure they're gonna allow us filming there, but we're gonna go in there. Okay. We just got out of the Venezuelan embassy. pretty much told us the same thing that Ariane told us, except for the fact that she's like, she's gonna talk to some people about getting us on a military plane on Saturday. She's like, but she's like, I can't guarantee that.
What is remarkable, though, is that the ambassador gives us her son Eduardo's email address and phone number in Venezuela, if we make it there.
So 11, 10, so something leaving every day. Venezuela, but anywhere south, I'm trying to find a ride.
That's funny.
It's not, it's kind of funny, but we're stuck.
Take a plane.
What's up? That was cool. Our first official hitchhike on Harlem for free. Couple nice guys.
You know Jay Grimner?
Who? Jay always said, like, come to the port and then look for Element.
He's a friend of Jay Grimner?
Thank you.
Okay.
How are you? I'm Alex. Anyway, south. I mean, I'll work too. Like, then we work on the boats. I can pretty much do anything.
Can't promise you anything right now, but I think I have a guy who can probably bring you as far as Trinidad.
Trinidad, we're close to South America, right?
We're close to
Venezuela. Trinidad would be good.
This is crazy.
I know. This is the radio station, right? I was wondering, we're trying to make it around the world with the kindness of others. We're trying to get off of Dominica and head south. Is it possible for maybe anyone on the radio station to tell what we're doing?
We have to speak to the program director, but she's not available now.
That's right. This is Tina's dressing black. We wear that camisa negra. But this ain't no pop song. This is life. And I'm putting a red rose in my pocket. It's in the back of my heart. But it ain't no heart attack.
Hitchhiking home from me in downtown here in Roseau. And I just ran into Boys Water, and I have no clue what this is. What is this, man?
This is called Boabande, man. Your natural aphrodisiac.
Is this the, from the bark from the tree?
Yeah.
Jade was talking about that in the Emerald Pool, that the bark from the tree.
Boa is stand-up wood, and that's basically what the bark of the tree does.
When's a typical time you would take a drink of this?
Well, normally you drink this when you're having lunch.
So people are taking it during lunch?
Yeah, lunchtime, because when you eat, it passes through your bloodstream. You get this erection, you want to have fun.
All right, man.
All right, cool.
Take it easy, bro.
At Jay's house, it's back to working the phones.
I was curious if anything came through on possibly getting us out of here, potentially get on that boat that was heading to Trinidad.
Really?
Oh, man. Well, here's the thing.
All the options we've had in Dominica, is just not many people coming and going.
Okay.
So far, everything's coming up short.
Yeah, no worries, man.
Let me call you right back, and I hung up.
Besides teaching French, Jay's also a musician, and he sometimes jams with this guy, Junior, whose wife, Mikkel, is one of the Caribbean's top singers.
Je parle français, mais je parle pas français.
But that's easy. Moi aimé is like totally easy.
Okay.
Moi aimé.
Moi aimé.
Perfect. It means I love you.
Oh, that's nice.
It's a little sudden,
Yes, I know.
Mikkel not only gives us some great tracks, she puts us in touch with local radio owner Frankie though, right? At Kyrie FM.
He's like, hey, he's like, you come to my radio station. He's like, I'm going to sort it out. I'm going to talk to like our advertisers, see what we can do about getting you to Trinidad.
We get that a lot.
When I heard
that, you know, you say that you, like, stop here for
coffee.
I don't
want to
stop here.
Oh, cool. That's awesome, man. That's awesome.
Frankie's morning news colleague does an on-the-spot interview with me.
So tell us about this adventure that you're on.
It's wild. It's crazy. You guys live on an unbelievable island. Yeah. I mean, this is so beautiful. And
we'll take a bow.
And you're beautiful women like yourself, you know what I mean?
Well,
so, you know. Not too shabby.
And literally, within minutes, support starts pouring in.
How you doing? I'm Alex.
Hi, Shelly.
Thank you so much. And what are my options to get to the airport from here?
Some travelers, you see?
Money taxi. You got two fellas that travel around the world. You heard about them? They catch any flight at 2:45 to Trinidad.
Come here, man.
You're there.
Hey, man.
okay.
Hey, man.
I know you guys are gonna go all the way around the world in 6 months.
I hope so, man.
And I know it's gonna be good because you have a good spirit. You really do have a good spirit.
Thanks
and,
a lot.
And when you're all done, come back here.
Absolutely.
And
come back and chill for like a
couple
month.
Months.
The story goes on.
Coming up on Around the World for Free.
Trinidad, represent.
Think we've seen everything the Caribbean has to offer?
I guess like shark is huge here in Trinidad, and this is black tip reef shark.
Think again.
Hey, this is like a half hour from Porto, Spain. Some of the most beauty we've seen in the Caribbean, to be honest.
That's next. We've enjoyed the breathtaking beauty.
This is it, peeps. Virgin Gorda.
And great hospitality of the Caribbean.
We're gonna miss you, Deborah.
Gonna miss you too.
And now we have one more jewel to see.
All right, we've been island hopping for the past 4 hours. I'm Dominica, Antigua, St. Vincent, Grenada, Grenada. We checked our email saying be careful in Porto, Spain. Very dangerous. Don't walk the streets. Hopefully someone's there.
Welcome to Trinidad. We have just landed.
It's gonna be an interesting day, isn't it? Yeah, man. What's up, man? What's your name, man?
Trevor.
Hey, what's up, man?
So I follow the morning talk shows, and I was just switching from station to station.
Good old Frankie at Kyrie FM. Our message got out just in time.
I saw two guys, and I said, hey, is this Alex?
Good, I didn't know if I was going to sleep on the streets tonight.
Two foreigners sleeping on the streets.
Yeah.
That would be trouble.
Why is that? Just the poverty?
Well, there's a lot of money. It's just that, you know, some guys believe they could grab what is yours, you know what I mean?
We're in a big city again, AB. What's
I know, it's weird being back in a big city. Like, we haven't seen a skyline since Puerto Rico.
There are a lot of different races in Trinidad. So you find Africans, you find Chinese, you find Indians.
I'm telling you, I am a curry expert.
Yeah?
Yeah, my mother used to crave curry when she was pregnant with me. Yes. The best road in Trinidad. I come here all the time.
Once you're in Trinidad, you must step on this piece of concrete at Smokey and Bundy.
This is the party area of Senate. Never sleep.
Trinidad, represent.
Trevor, this is great.
Oh, man. This morning, you know, he's up and at him. He's got stuff to do, so he's like, hey, guys, let me bring you to my little breakfast nook and get you guys a little hot double. Not only is it hot, but it's spicy hot, too. Like, really spicy hot. Here on Trinidad, they have oil and gas, so this island's very rich. And Trevor, you know, he is one of these construction consultants here.
Professionals like me, with a college degree, you can move freely within CARICOM. CARICOM is a grouping of Caribbean countries.
Trevor, man. Trevor just stepped up, huge. Yeah.
This guy is traveling the world for free. I'm not buying a ticket for him to go to Venezuela.
Oh, you're doing well.
Tickets to Venezuela. Caracas. Naturally, we are just helpful people. We are loving people. We care about each other.
So we're on our way.
But before we leave, it's not too late to cram in a quick tour of the island.
We're going to Maracas Beach. We're going to get some bacon shack.
Here we go. Like round we do. I'ma hold on to that wheel and I ain't never letting go. And if you really think you could get it, then come on, let me know. Put me on a pedestal, slow down, this is what you better do. A beast complex, the streets want this. Khalees concepts, leave no contest.
Richard is the number one bacon shack chef in Trinidad and Tobago.
Whenever you come to Maracas, you have to come here. I guess like shark is huge here in Trinidad, and this is black tip reef shark.
Fresh cilantro stuff, and a garlic spread, tamarind sauce.
That's awesome. This island has it all. The city, you got the nightlife, you can make money. And take a look. Hey, this is like a half hour from Porto, Spain. Some of the most beauty we've seen in the Caribbean, to be honest.
On our last night in Trinidad, before flying out to Caracas, we go hang out with more of Trevor's friends.
You know, you just have to be careful how things are in Caracas. All right, so you have to look out for robberies or somebody coming to ask you for a little money. Might take your wallet, your money or something. Anywhere else besides Caracas, Puerto La Margarita, is okay, but try your best to stay out of Caracas.
Real, 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 back at Trevor's.
Just as long as you guys can get us like set up maybe for the first night or two. Yeah, we don't. I mean, right now we don't.
Even Venezuelan members of our web community confirm our fears.
Listen to everyone talk about Caracas and how dangerous. I mean, every person is like, do not talk to anyone. Do not go with anyone. These are people who live in the country. I'm like a little nervous of like Caracas, you know what I mean? In 12 hours, buddy.